Hey guys, today I'm going to be talking about the potential security implications of using an Android device, including Android head units. Okay, firstly, don't be discouraged from using any Android head unit or an AI box. They are absolutely the very best option for improving your car infotainment and adding useful features. You'll be completely safe if you follow the guidance I offer in this video, and I'll keep it brief. I should say that to this day, I have never heard of anyone who has had any accounts compromised through Android head units, and it is highly unlikely that anything bad will happen to you. But as I work in open source IT, I know what the possibilities are. And as Android head units are getting increasingly popular, there is a chance that they may be targeted by opportunists. You'll probably already have heard me go on about the beauty of Android head units and how they allow you to do pretty much whatever you want. And one of the first things that you'll probably do when you get an Android head unit is put your Google credentials into Google Play so that you can download and install any apps that you want to use. I'm going to take this opportunity to briefly step away from the car head unit topic and talk about your Google account. Aside from the App Store, your Google account gives you access to Google Maps, Photos, YouTube, Google Drive, Google Calendar, your contacts, Google Search, Chrome, and email. And now let's consider the implications of what might happen in the unlikely event that someone with malicious intent gained access to your Google account. Maps is going to tell them where you've been, the calendar is going to tell you where you're going to be, Photos is going to show them a historic repository of all your personal photos and videos. YouTube is bad if you're a creator like me and someone gets access to it, that's not going to be good. Drive might contain some personal files if you use it. Contacts are going to give them access to people that you know, and that could be bad for blackmail, or they might try to fish your friends. Google Search is going to give them your search history. Chrome is going to give them your browsing history. And the other thing about Chrome is if you're one of these people that saves passwords in your browser and in Chrome, which you shouldn't do because it's not encrypted, they're going to have access to all your passwords as well. And then there's Google Email, which is the most catastrophic thing for anyone to get access to, because that means that they have all your emails, so they can see what accounts you have set up all over the internet, and they can just reset your password and gain access to those accounts because they have access to your inbox. Generally speaking, if you're a Google service user, your account absolutely should be protected by a very strong and complex password, and you must use two-factor authentication. That will prevent logins even if the attacker has your password, and you'll be notified that someone has tried to access your account. The same goes for Apple and other providers if you use their similar services. Okay, with that in mind, let's return to the main subject of Android head units. There are three main things to take into consideration. Firstly, remember that a head unit is an unsecured computer, which means that if your car was stolen or the head unit was stolen out of your car, the thief would instantly have access to your whole life. Basically, anyone who has physical access to the head unit has the opportunity to access your stuff. Secondly, Android head unit packaging is rarely factory sealed. When you buy a shiny new tablet or phone, it will have security seals on the packaging, preventing other people from tampering with them before they get to you. When a device is unsealed, what's to stop someone from intercepting the package and installing something to monitor your usage? The same question could be raised for unbranded Android head units. You never know what background software has been installed to collect your data. And lastly, Samsung phones or iPhones will receive constant patches and other updates. And these are not just adding new features, they're also fixing security issues that have been highlighted over time. Android head units do not have this feature. So am I saying that you should not log into Google services on an Android head unit? No, I'm not. You should, because it unlocks all the useful features that makes a head unit great. There's a very simple solution to eradicate the security issues I just mentioned. Do not use your main Google account. There's simply no reason to use your main Google account on a car radio. Instead, create a second account to use in your car. It's as simple as that to enjoy Android head units in the safest possible way. So in conclusion, it's totally safe to use Android head units and the AI boxes, but just use a secondary Google account. Don't log in using your main Google account. I hope this video is useful, and I'll have some more reviews for you coming up soon.